Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Fred Caldwell of Acadia. And a little show and tell. This is 1992 in Acadia Roadside Park. And to the left is Mayor Maura Wiegand. She's planting an evergreen tree. And to the right in the helmet is Mark Wisniewski. He was with People for Trees. And I think it was, it took about 3 hours to plant 101 trees that afternoon, morning. In last year, 2000, whatever it is, in 2008, that tree was torn down accidentally in the park. That was pretty disturbing. But go to the next picture, please. In 1993, that's President Howard Greenwood, he's deceased. That's Mayor Gil Hanno. And that was planted 2000, where the city planted a lot more trees. That's Orpheus Park. And one more picture. That's me and Sheila Cameron, Mayor Sheila Cameron, later on, and Howard again. And that's what it looked like the first day we planted those trees. Now they're all gone. But I just have one question for the record. And whose idea was it to take the trees down? I really want to know. I don't want to be told it was staff or it was a homeowners association. It had to be one person initially, and I'd like to know who that person is. Thank you.
The next is Sheila Cameron.
Good evening, Sheila Cameron, Lucadia. I'm not sure I look the same from the back anymore, but 15 years ago, 10 pounds less. Okay, first of all, I'd like this question answered at some point in time. Doesn't have to be tonight. You can write me or something. But I don't understand why you had two meetings tonight. First of all, you had a Santa Anita Water District and Housing Authority. There was no Santa Anita Water District report. There was no Housing Authority report. There were no Housing Authority representatives here. Everything on here, everything could have gone on the regular agenda. Could have had a five-minute special meeting and a regular agenda meeting. Okay, I think most of you probably read the article I wrote for the Coast News, and if you didn't, I'd ask you to do that. I'd like to know where the citizen participation was regarding the trees in Orpheus. There was none. The mayor said we're not going to be making knee-jerk decisions. Well, there's an example of one, a knee-jerk decision. And I do want to know also, I'll echo Fred, who did okay this? I talked with several condo owners, and I met not one person who said that they wanted the trees cut down. Not one. I talked to a lot of them. They said they'd been trimmed in the past, and that's all they asked for. And in my article, one of the condo owners told me that the city simply said they weren't going to trim them anymore. And that is the jobs of Park and Rec. One of the jobs is to take care of parks and do the maintenance on them, and that's what was promised. I'd like to just make one comment about the children and maybe the overreach or abuse of power on the part of one council person to say to kids to come down on teachers, come down on the principal, write the superintendent of schools. Unbelievable for them participating in a democratic process. Okay, the emails that went out from some city council members, again, down Gallagher and Jerome Stocks. There was a violation of the Brown Act because these constituted a serial meeting, and that's a fact. But also, it was the content and the kind of nasty and hateful remarks that were made. You know, we had children here tonight, these children saying, use kind words. And I think what could happen is if you'd start with yourselves and your relationship with each other, and it would extend to all of us. I agree with Mark Wisniewski. Magnolia trees are absolutely the worst tree you can plant in that position. And also the trees that you have up front are going to grow up and going to block the view and create a safety hazard, because you need to have a view down into that park to see what's going on with kids. That's all I have to say tonight. It's been a very sad thing and a real wound to the heart of everybody who lives here. Thanks.
Dolores Welty in Leucadia. how long have y'all lived here? Don't you know how we feel about trees in Leucadia? I'm just amazed. We have a prayer ceremony practically when we have to take one down in the Leucadia Park. I was one of the people who actually helped plant some of those 101 trees along 101. I understand about views. My house is actually in the way of a longtime resident here, and she hates it, and you should probably come and take it down so she could have a view, the old view that she was used to. Or my friend, Marcia. Somebody built a house right in front of her, and she no longer has the view she once had. If these trees were removed for view, who are you trying to kid? I'm not getting gentle. I also understand that there's a thought that some of the trees along 101 need to be taken out. It's been mentioned, and maybe it's only a rumor, that you've marked 16 of the eucalyptus to be removed. I would like to know why. What's wrong with them if that is true? And who has made sure that they are not healthy? Have you talked to Mark? He helps us understand when trees have to go. We understand him and we trust him, and he's very knowledgeable. We like our trees. We like our views. We don't want to take someone's view away. We really don't. We want trees to be maintained. I agree that we need some kind of way either to teach the people who made this decision or who thought it was all right to just go ahead and do what they wanted without letting people know. We need a way to inform staff or elected officials or somebody. We like our trees. We want to talk it over. We do not want to be surprised.